Well, the original inspiration was pure good fortune. We got lost. My wife and I found ourselves in a tiny village in the Pyrenees called Lescun, staying in a hotel. Little girl comes in with a book, and the book is Cheval de Guerre, which is war horse in French. And she said, could you sign it? Because she'd heard I come to the village. I signed it. And then she said, oh, and my daddy says, could you come lunch tomorrow? Well, he's the mayor of the village. It had 100 people in it, you know, we're talking about a big place. So we went up there, and I found out this guy was a farmer. He kept sheep on the mountains, and we got talking. And he told me he was 10 when the Germans arrived in his village to occupy it in 1943. They stayed there for over 2 years, and during that time, they were preventing or trying to prevent people escaping over the border into Spain, particularly Jewish people and a lot of Jewish children who were on their own. And he said they didn't know it at the time, but there was an old lady living in this village who quietly was looking after these children in a safe house, a barn, under the noses of the Germans. If she'd been caught, she'd have been shot. And group by group, they were being taken over the border to safety. She probably saved the lives of hundreds of children. And this sort of thing went on all over France. You know, we hear of Jews being handed over time and time again, which they were. But there were brave people. There were extraordinary people. And I thought it was a story worth recording. So that's what I did.
Why do you feel it is so important to revisit this particular portion of our history now in 2020?
Well, I was glad to hear you say it was our history, because it is our history. I think it's because we are still thinking in terms of them and us. It's one of the worst things that has gone on. You know, them, refugees, migrants, call them what you like, are them, we are us. And once you start that, and there is suspicion, which can turn so easily to hate and resentment. That's how the Holocaust happened. It wasn't an accident. This was people who had hate in their hearts, and that can happen again. And it's the biggest warning humanity's ever had, never to go down the road again. The problem is, as we get more distant from it, people are losing the memory of it. Why wouldn't you? Anyway, you don't want to remember it. It's a really unpleasant thing to think about, that 6 million of these people were murdered. It's not something humanity can ever be proud of. And the problem is that the seed of that, which is a resentment of Jews, anti-Semitism, is hiding away down there. And if we feed it with hate, this thing can rise again. So I think it's really important that you tell stories which tell the truth about this. And the truth is, of course, that this thing happened, and that it's a warning to us to tell the story on and on, because the people who lived it are going now. The last ones are going to be dying. It's up to storytellers like me now to tell the story as it happened. And that way, hopefully, it won't happen again. That's what it's about.